On behalf of the ENMU College of Fine Arts and Department of Music, welcome to another outstanding musical performance. Please turn off your cell phones, pagers, and watch alarms at this time. Photography is prohibited during performances. Photographs may be taken when the performance has concluded. Thank you.
Thank you. To reflect back on that first piece, allegedly it's by Rossini. Now, unfortunately, history has kind of lost some evidence. If we look at all of his catalogs from the time, there's no indication that he actually wrote that work, but perhaps the attribution comes from the fact that it uses two themes from works within his opera, so who knows? On the flip side of the coin, and now for something completely different, we definitely know the composer of the next work, and it contains a number of Brahmsian hallmarks. So as you're listening, things to kind of pick out. Brahms really liked to traverse a lot of space in his melodies, and you're going to hear that in this piece. You're also going to hear some ambiguity of rhythm, and I know some of my music reading students are sitting out there saying, ambiguity and rhythm, Dr. Schuller, you would fail him, right? Well, it's a Brahmsian hallmark. At times you'll hear what sounds like a downbeat, but if you look at the score, it's not actually a downbeat. And there will be times where Mrs. Polk will be playing in two, and I'm in three, and vice versa, so it really leads to this ambiguity of rhythm that Brahms has. Also, another difference, the first work that you heard is very much a solo for clarinet, and it was originally written for orchestra. Now we have a piano transcription. The other piece that we're going to hear next by Brahms, very much intended for clarinet and piano. It's far more intimate between the two voices and the way that they react and create the texture. So without further ado, Brahms' second clarinet sonata.
Thank you. picture of him in the suit where he shows his
thank you. Thank you.
Dr. Jeff Gentry, the Dean of the College of Fine Arts, and also Mr. Dustin Seifert, our Music Department Chair. I'd also like to thank Drs. Laubenthal and Dr. Schuler, and of course, the fantastic Mrs. Holm for collaborating on the music this evening. All right, so I promised you, and now for something different. So if you think back to the recital, we started out with some inspiration from Italian vocal music, we traversed through the German Romantic era, we hit up some Mexican rhythms and dance music, you just heard a nice stout English piece, and now for something completely different. So the next work is actually by a Belgian composer, and it's always kind of been a theme to do this, but recently it's really been happening within the clarinet world, to take music that is folk music and bring it to the concert stage, and that's exactly what this composer has done. So what type of folk music? Well, he used klezmer as his inspiration. So now Patrick Hicketick's piece, which translates into Yiddish, and the next word kind of means sentiment, if you will.
Thank you. Thank you.